You're about to embark on a journey to explore the stellar system of TOI-700 and discover what lies beyond our planet. Who knows, we may find a planet with sentient life on it. So buckle up and join us as we explore the unfamiliar world of exoplanets. Our mission today is to discover whether the planets of TOI-700 could sustain life. We'll be studying the star system, the four planets orbiting it, and the conditions which could make a planet habitable. What we discover could be rock-solid evidence of life beyond our planet. So let's explore. There are many planets out there in the universe, and scientists think that one of them might have people living on it. Space scientists look carefully at the sky to try to find signs of these people, and they hope one day they will be able to find the planet that has people living on it. It might be a long time until we find it, but it's exciting to think about. Keep watching to explore the possibility of life with us. We hear the word exoplanet everywhere we go now. But what is it? Exoplanets are planets that are not in our own solar system. Scientists have discovered lots of them since 1990, and some of them are close enough that we might be able to get a picture of them and find out if anyone lives there in the future. How do we find these planets? TESS is a special mission that NASA is running right now to find planets around stars in outer space. Scientists just discovered a new star called TOI-700 that has four planets orbiting around it. Recent discoveries have revealed that the star system may hold two Earth-sized planets that could potentially be inhabitable, making it a promising prospect in the search for extraterrestrial life beyond the solar system. Regarding our exploration of inhabited planets beyond our solar system, we must confront how little we know today. There is no way for us to accurately assess how often life occurs across the universe and where it could be most probable to emerge. Because conditions for life could be predictable, as the universe is constant with its laws and what gets it to work, we think that it is possible to narrow down our requirements, therefore making it easier to create the habitable planet prototype. It's just like a little young girl drawing down her perfect idea of a partner. So the perfect planet has the following boxes to tick. 1. Rocky planet like our Earth. 2. Has a thin atmosphere. 3. Being a certain size similar to Earth's size. 4. Having liquid water, meaning 5. Being close enough for us to study its biosignatures. 6. Orbits a star with a steady and consistent energy output. 7. With a similar amount of heavy elements as our solar system has. 8. When sufficient time has elapsed to bring about considerable changes to the planet's biosphere. The first requirement for the emergence of life is a suitable star. If the mass of the star is too great, its evolution will be rapid and any life on the planet's surface will be scorched in a few hundred million years, not allowing for elaboration. On the contrary, if the star is of the less massive red dwarf kind, the planet must be situated in a tight orbit to obtain adequate stellar energy, but atmospheres will be too vulnerable to the star's flaring to endure. A midpoint has to exist where long-term habitability could be probable. A significant consideration, one that might be just as critical as the first one, is the composition of the planet we are exploring. We are interested in planets that have a solid surface we can stand on and a thin layer of air like Earth so that life forms like us can live on them. This means that planets have to be just the right size. They can't be too big or too small. Planets that are too big have thick atmospheres that make it too hard for living things like us to survive. But if the planet isn't big enough, it can't hold onto an atmosphere. The perfect size for a planet is about twice as big as Earth and only 25 to 30% bigger. The discoveries of more than 5,000 exoplanets have been documented and noted, yet very few would be favorable for the possibility of life due to their large sizes and the volatile composition of gas surrounding them. Most of the exoplanets, which are of comparable size to Earth, are too warm, as they are near their stars and past the definition of a habitable zone. Scientists have found exciting planets that are far away from us in space. However, these planets are too close to stars that are constantly shooting out strong rays of energy. This energy might be too powerful, and it could cause these planets to lose their atmospheres, which makes them a bad place for life to survive. That is why the system encircling the star TOI-700 makes it a great candidate. Let's talk about some characteristics of the star. It's a red dwarf, part of the M category of stars. In less technical words, that means that it should be a small, cool star. It's more or less one-third the size of our Sun and only 1/100th of its brightness. However, it still manages to emit enough light and heat for the orbiting planets to be potentially habitable. While the temperature of the star is still a matter of debate, some research has suggested it is roughly 1300 Kelvin. In addition to its temperature and size, the brightness of the star is important to note. In terms of absolute brightness, TOI-700 is quite faint. However, in terms of nearby stars, it is only about 20% dimmer than the other stars in its region. This could mean it could sustain a planet with life. Another important factor in examining a star's habitability is analyzing its rotation rate. Knowing how fast the star is spinning around its axis will indicate how stable the system is, and therefore how hospitable the environment is for planetary habitability. TOI-700 is spinning relatively slowly, making it an attractive candidate for sustenance. TOI-700 has also existed for over 1.5 billion years, giving life plenty of time to develop a biosphere in the thin layer which separates the planet's surface and its atmosphere. If a biosphere were to form here, it would have the potential to drastically alter the planet's atmosphere. All of these factors together make TOI-700 an excellent candidate for hosting a potentially habitable planet. The star is relatively small and cool, with a moderate brightness and rotation rate that is not too fast. With all of this in mind, let us move on to the planets in the system. It has recently been confirmed that TOI-700, originally discovered by the test mission to have three planets orbiting it, now has at least four, two of which could potentially be habitable. The known exoplanets orbiting TOI-700 include TOI-700b, a super-Earth with a radius 1.43 times that of Earth, orbiting its star once every 10.3 days at a distance of 0.07 AU. TOI-700c, a mini-Neptune with a radius 2.6 times that of Earth, orbiting its star once every 16.1 days at a distance of 0.10 AU. TOI-700D, a sub-Earth with a radius 1.05 times that of Earth, orbiting its star once every 36.2 days at a distance of 0.17 AU. It's the first Earth-like planet to ever be discovered by TESS that is also in the habitable zone. TOI-700E, a mini-Neptune with a radius 0.95 times that of Earth, orbiting its star once every 16 days at a distance of 0.09 AU. The four planets all orbit within their star's habitable zone, meaning they could potentially support liquid water and life. Scientists are eager to get a closer look at these worlds to learn more about their composition and potential habitability. Beyond the habitable zone that we define to be not too far nor too close to the host star, the extended or optimistic habitable zone, yet to be discovered, could still enable surface liquid water under the correct conditions with some minor modifications to the atmosphere of the planet. The TOI-700 system is like a neighborhood with four planets or houses. Two of the planets, TOI-700b and C, are too hot to have living things like people or animals, so we don't have to worry about them. They are the closest to the star. The two other planets are the perfect temperature for people to live in and might have people living on them. That's exciting. They are more probable of being rocky planets, far enough for them to not be annihilated by the stellar activity of TOI-700. The study we have conducted on the star TOI-700 so far suggests that the habitable zone of the star stretches far more than the placement of TOI-700d. That means that there could be another rocky planet located in the habitable zone of the star that we have yet to observe with more data from TESS. There is much debate on the viability of life around an M-class red dwarf star. These stars usually cause their orbiting planets to become tidally locked, so one side always faces the star and the other side faces away. There's so much to look forward to in the project of studying this stellar system. Soon, tests will begin observing the area of the sky which holds TOI-700 and its planets, gathering data that can show if more planets exist beyond the ones discovered. Observations via the ESPRESSO instrument on the ESO's Very Large Telescope have been allocated to assess the motion of TOI-700 over time. These observations are expected to be advantageous in calculating the masses of the planets around the star, especially the closest ones. Furthermore, data we are expecting to receive from new survey research regarding the ultraviolet spectrum of the star could potentially yield valuable insights into the atmospheric behaviors and properties of its orbiting planets. For example, planets in our solar system can be hot, but some of them still have the right conditions that could make them livable. If they have lots of carbon dioxide in their atmosphere, their air will be warm like a blanket and strong winds will be blowing all around the planet. Even though it won't be easy for life to live there, it's still possible for some things to survive if the planet has a lot of water. We are getting closer to finding life beyond Earth by using current and upcoming observatories, such as Habitable Worlds Observatory and the LUVOIR mission. The Habitable Worlds Observatory, a ground-based observatory located in Chile, is helping us find potentially habitable exoplanets in our galaxy. The observatory can detect exoplanets that could sustain life using advanced imaging and spectroscopic analysis. So far, the observatory has discovered over 20 planets in the habitable zone, which means they can have liquid water on their surface and could potentially support life. In addition to the Habitable Worlds Observatory, the upcoming LUVOIR mission has the potential to find even more evidence of extraterrestrial life. Launching in the 2030s, LUVOIR is an unmanned mission to seek out and study exoplanets in our galaxy. The mission is equipped with several instruments that will allow it to detect the presence of life-sustaining elements such as water, oxygen, and carbon. The LUVOIR mission also has the potential to take images of exoplanets that could help us determine whether they are capable of supporting life. The star system of TOI-700 is an exciting prospect for the search for extraterrestrial life. With four planets located within their star's habitable zone, the likelihood of discovering life on one of them increases significantly. While the star is relatively small and cool, its moderate brightness and rotation makes it an ideal candidate for supporting habitable planets. Through ongoing research and advancements in technology, we can further explore the system and increase our understanding of the possibility of life beyond Earth. That's all for this video. If you have a theory on your own on whether there's life outside of Earth, don't hesitate to let us know in the comments. We are interested in what you think. Thanks for watching. See you later. And don't forget to like and subscribe to stay updated with our newest, most exciting subjects.